So it's my experience that sometimes a piece of electronics simply will not acknowledge your presence until you introduce it to some leverage. You are looking at the Merlin Expresscard 54. It's a WAN card, which means wideband wireless, different from WLAN. And what I'm going to do is see if I can recover a mini PCIe type control card from inside here. As you can see, here's the SIM slot where you can store one. Here's the extra adapter for power. Here's where you insert the SIM card. And basically, there's one screw. I can show it to you here. There, where my thumb is. And we're going to proceed from there to see if we can recover a card that can be used internally instead of requiring the express card slot. It's a hex head style screw, so I put on the appropriate adapter for that, and I'm just starting to do this one-handed. I don't know why, because the view isn't that great. Let me get this off camera. So it's my experience that sometimes a piece of electronics simply will not acknowledge your presence until you introduce it to some leverage. Now I'm going to play another little game with it. This is the sardine can, and we're the hungry Norwegians. You can see I've used my handy-dandy multi-tool to just roll this right open. And here we have the card. It is unlikely to fit in the internal mini PCIe slot, but what the hell? Had to look. So let me show you the card here. This is the last view you saw. And now we can just take the card out of the case. Both sides of the card. Normally, the size we're looking for would end right where the green area turns to metal. And that would be the card we would put in the WWAN slot of the notebook. But they've done this whole funky configuration here, and you can see it goes back to the green PC board there. You can see the green on the opposite end just a little bit, and so it's all one piece, and that's not what we're looking for. I had been thinking maybe they had possibly done an adapter to a mini PCIe card, and then it could just be put in the notebook. And like sometimes you'll get, I think Western Digital is most famous for doing this. You'll buy an external hard drive, and they'll have a little adapter inside attached to a regular hard drive with the control board, and that'll feed their special software, their backup software stuff, to your machine. So it's not necessary in a situation like that. I was hoping this might be a similar one, but it's not. Are these actual? I'm thinking these might be dip switches, but I have to look at it closely anyway. This is just, you're seeing it as I'm seeing it. All right, so our experiment to see if a very antiquated external express card format wideband wireless card could be retrofitted, could be extracted and retrofitted to fit, you know, regular WWAN slots in notebooks. And in this case, with this particular model, what is it, the Merlin XU870 or XJ870, it could not. I have no experience in doing these procedures, but I thought it might be interesting just to take a look. So that's what we've done today. Cheers.
Oh, what the hell? If you're here, it's pretty clear that I should be giving you the whole show. So let's take off this little heatsink shielding here and see what we have underneath. I picked this up on warehouse deals, so it was only like 73 cents or something like that. Yeah. Processing chips, it's a Qualcomm. And let's see what we've got on the other side. Yeah, I have never used a notebook that's had one of these in the ExpressCard slot. I have a ThinkPad that I have a memory module in an ExpressCard slot. That's about it. There you go. Little heat shields off. That's what one of these suckers looks like on the inside. You're seeing it as I'm seeing it. I'm not familiar with these things. And of course the connection for the express card. All those little pins, huh? This should be like Star Trek, Star Wars. The big battle cruiser comes into the frame, you know?